Hello everybody, it's Rob here for today's live English quiz from BBC Learning English. It's great to be here and it's great to see you out there. How are you all doing today? Yep, good, fantastic. Do send me your messages, of course, to find out where you're watching from. So we have our usual Friday live quiz. It's 1:30 here in the UK. It might be the morning or the evening, wherever you are in the world, but it's great that you're watching. We have this live quiz every Friday, and we have how many questions? Can you remember? I'll tell you. Yeah, we've got 8 questions to come. 8 questions testing your English knowledge about grammar, vocabulary, idioms, just general English knowledge. And of course, don't worry if you don't know the answers, because it's Friday. We're just having fun. We're just having fun. So have a guess if you don't know what the answers are. If you do know, great. Tell me the answers. We'll have the answers first, and then we'll have the have the questions first, and then we'll have the answers later on. So we have 8 questions to come. The answers come afterwards. And today's theme, in case you don't already know, is it's all about cycling. Yes, we are talking cycling and bikes. I love cycling. I cycle everywhere. I use a bike for work. I use a bike for leisure. In fact, you can probably see there's my bike parked over there, because as soon as this quiz is over, I am going for a bike ride. I have my cycle helmet already here. Got to be safe. Yeah. So there's my cycle helmet already. Do you like cycling? Do tell me. Do tell me in the chat. All your messages appear here at the side of the screen, so I can see them all coming in. So do send me your comments and your messages. Now, just going back to the quiz, just to remind you, of course, we have a lot of fun, but it is just for fun. We don't have any prizes other than the excitement and the glory of having your name appearing here on the screen. I will be picking some of the answers that appear in the comments and put them on screen. So you might see your name in lights. Wouldn't that be fantastic? But there are no prizes other than that. We're just going to have some fun. And the most important thing, of course, I say this every week, is to like, to comment. Oh, it's gone. There you go. It was there a minute ago. Like, comment, and share. Yeah, like this quiz, send me your comments and share it and tell your friends. We want the whole world watching our live English quiz, don't we? Yes, we do. Now, as I said, I like to know where you're watching from. So let's go to the messages and see what people are saying. This is why I keep looking to one side, because I'm reading your messages. I'm not being rude. Here we go. Okay, let's find out where you're watching from today. And let's find out also if you like cycling. Okay. We have a hello coming in here from, my buttons aren't working. Hello from, and Shika is in India. So hello to everybody in India. We have people in Pakistan. We have people watching in Colombia today. Greetings from Colombia I've got here. Come on, messages, that's it. Jill says hello from Colombia. Hello, Colombia today. We have people in watching in Algeria. Sorry, I'm pressing the buttons. They're not all appearing, but I'm doing my best here. Okay, Sarah says that she's interested in cycling, but can't cycle very well. It doesn't matter. If you can't ride a bike, you can still take part in the quiz. Don't worry. We have people in Belgium today. So hello to people in Belgium watching. We've got India. We've got people watching in Iraq. So hello to everyone in Iraq today. Let's get this one. India, yes. Bangladesh as well. People watching in Bangladesh. Hello. Hey, Iskander. Nice to see you. Well, Mohammed's going to enjoy the quiz today, because he says I like cycling so much, which is wonderful. We have Leah in the beautiful city of Palermo in Italy, which is fantastic. Douglas is in Brazil and lots of other people in Brazil. So hello to Brazil. We also have Noshin in Malaysia. Dana is in Mexico City. Oh, can't get your message up, but never mind. Yes, Bangladesh, India, Nepal as well. Yep, you really are all over the world today, which makes me very happy. So keep sending me your messages from where you're watching from. I'm very nosy. I like to know where you are. I'm here at home in the UK, just outside London. And we're almost ready to start the quiz. Are you ready to start the quiz? Good. I said, if you like cycling, fantastic. If you don't like cycling or can't ride a bike, it really doesn't matter. We're going to have fun. testing your English knowledge today, because this is the live English quiz from BBC Learning English with me. Yes, it's me, Rob, today. And we also have coming up very soon a special guest. We always have a special guest with a special question. So hang around for our special guest and our special question. But now I think it's time, don't you, to get on with the quiz. So let me get my quiz ready for you. Bear with me. It's coming very soon. Very, very soon. Okay. Should we share this? And we'll share this. And we can begin. I'm not very prepared, am I, today? Right, let's go to question one. Question one on the theme of cycling is coming up very soon once I press the right buttons. Okay, stand by, everybody. It'll be worth the wait. Okay. Okay, can you see the quiz already? Excellent. Let's begin now, shall we, with question number one. And on my live quiz, and you can tell it's live because I am making some mistakes here. Let's just get this going again. Bear with me, folks. I've got the wrong button pressed here. Right, here we go. This is going to work. Okay, question one on the theme of cycling. Here it is. So, what do you call someone who rides a bike? Does this sound like an easy question to you? What do you call someone who rides a bike? Is it a cycler? Is it cycling? Cyclist or cyclist? Cycler, cycling, cyclist or cyclist? Is that an easy question? Maybe not. What do we call someone who rides a bike? Give me your answers. Write them in the comments. They're coming in thick and fast just here. And let's see what people are saying. Okay. Right. Yara says C. So cyclist, cyclist. We have a lot of people saying C, cyclist, but not everybody. Afsana says cycling. Cycling is someone who rides a bike. Someone who rides a bike. Let's get some other names up here on the screen. Diana says C. Badasso says C as well. What about other options? Cycler, cycling, cyclist or cyclist? What do you think it is? Oh, goodness. The messages are coming in so fast, I can hardly click on them. Right. Sam says, okay, let's just put a few more examples up. Okay, C is correct. Clara says it's A, a cycler. Cycler is somebody who cycles a bike. Let's have another look. Okay, Mumail says also cycler. A lot of you also saying A, cycler. So we've got two kind of front runners here. Some people are saying cycler and some people are saying cyclist. Right, okay. I will give you the answer later on. Questions first, answers later. Okay, keep sending your messages in. All right, shall we move on? Yes, let's go to question number two, round two. And here's your second cycle-related question in our live quiz today from BBC Learning English. Have a look at this one. Now, if you need help, helping fixing your bike, just let me know. So what is the correct answer to that? If you need help, to help or helping fixing your bike, just let me know. What do you think the correct answer is? What should go in that gap? A, B or C? Right, let's have a look at what people are saying on question number two. And a lot of you are saying A, help. But we've got quite a few B's coming in here. To help. If you need to help fixing your bike, just let me know. Right, I'm going to put a few of your answers up on screen, so you might see your name appearing now. Quick hello to... Oh, I've just missed that message. Samba was in Mauritania. Hello there. Right, Hamza. Yeah, Anishka says help. Let's get some more. My little keypad's being very sensitive today, and not working as it should. Right, Hamza says A. Shazli says need to help. To help is the answer. Darshan is help. Ajaz says is A, help. AJ also says A, help. But we've got a few B's coming in here as well. Some of you think it's to help. If you need to help fixing your bike, just let me know. Who are Nora, for example, thinks it's answer B. Answer B. Okay, well, as I said, as always, we will give you the answers later on. So don't go anywhere. Somebody's saying helping. Answer C, helping. Okay. Mixed opinions, which is good. We like different answers. It means it's got you thinking and challenging. So do tell me, as I said, if you like cycling. We are talking about cycling today. What's your bike like? Small, big? Does it fold up? Is it a racing bike? Is it a mountain bike? Maybe it's a motorbike with an engine on it. Do tell me. Right, let's move on to question number 3. Don't forget, we have a special guest coming soon with a question as well. But now it's question number 3 on the theme of cycling. Have a look at this and have a read of this. Yeah. For the next 2 weeks, I something for the Tour de France. For the next 2 weeks, I something for the Tour de France. For the next 2 weeks, I will have been training for the Tour de France. For the next 2 weeks, I will be training for the Tour de France. Or for the next 2 weeks, I will be going for the Tour de France. Okay, what do you think the correct answer is there? If you don't know the answers, do have a guess. Do have a guess. So what are people saying? Let's have a look here. Right, so a few examples. Nunu says, I will have been training. Dilshad says, I will be training. I will be training. Renato also thinks the same. Seema says, I will be training. Okay. Oops, let's put this one here. Bia also thinks it's B, but we also have some people saying C. But every time I click on them, they're not working. Okay. Geneve says, A, I will have been training. Nora thinks it's B. I will be training. Who else we got here? Oh, come on, keyboard, please work. Right. We have an answer C here as well. I will be going for the Tour de France. Okay, well, once again, different answers coming in, which is fantastic. It's got you thinking, hasn't it? I will give out the answers later on. So just a reminder, you're watching the live quiz from BBC Learning English. We do this every Friday. We have 8 questions on a theme. This week's theme is cycling. And there is a question about the Tour de France. As you know, the Tour de France is a very exciting cycle race. It's probably the toughest sporting tournament of all time, I think. People have to cycle for, is it about 3 weeks, up mountains and all over the place, all over France, with a final in Paris. It's a very grueling and tough race, the Tour de France. Well, here we go. It says, for the next 2 weeks, I something for the Tour de France. What is the answer? I'll tell you later on. Okay, shall we move on? I think we should. I think we should have another question now. What about question 4 on the theme of cycling? It's our picture round, and all you have to do is match the English words with the pictures. Simple, isn't it? The words we have are spokes, pedals, and frame. Spokes, pedals, and frame. Okay, which picture is which word? Have a look at that, and then give me your answers. What do you think? What are people saying? So A is what? B is what? And C is what? Do tell me in the comments, and let's have a look now at what you are saying. So spokes, is spokes A, B or C? Is pedals A, B or C? And is frame A, B or C? Let's pick a few of your comments. Let's look at Daniela there. You think A is pedals, B is frame and C is spokes. Okay. What else we got going here? Isuru thinks A is pedals. Okay, A is pedals. We have some more answers. A, pedals, B, spokes, C, frame. Redda thinks A, pedals, B, frame, and C, spokes. Right, so we've got different answers coming in again. Wonderful, we like this. Grace says A, pedals, B, frame, C, spokes. Okay, Great. Let's put some more names up. Let's get your name on the screen. Give yourself a big shout. Shout out if you see your name on the screen. Go, yay, I'm on the screen. Tell your neighbours. You're famous at last all across BBC Learning English. Right, okay. What else we got? Yeah. A, B, and C. Yeah. Oh, good. Some good work coming in there. Well done. Right, okay. Well, as I said, these are our questions. The answers come later on. Right. Thank you for all those. Right, let's move on. And let's try and get rid of that message. Okay, exciting times now, because coming up, we have our special guest for question number 5. But who is this guest going to be today? Who do you think is going to join us on the show? Let's find out. Here she comes. Full screen. Hello, Sam.
Hello. Hello, Rob. Hello, everyone. How are you?
Yeah, I'm doing very well today. Sun is shining. I've got my bike ready for a bike ride.
So you're not wasting any time, are you, Rob? You're going to jump on the bike the minute this is over.
By the way, somebody's saying, is Paddington Bear our special guest? I'm afraid not.
Oh, today. I'm sorry. I'm probably a big disappointment. No. To the Queen, I think. He only has tea with the Queen. Yeah.
And you don't have a marmalade sandwich with you today.
I don't have a marmalade sandwich. I only have a very boring cup of tea, so I'm sorry. I'm not Paddington, I apologize.
Okay. Well, people are still pleased to see you. Lots of messages coming in to say hello, Sam.
Hello.
Let's put you up on screen here. Hello. So we're talking about cycling.
We are.
What about you? Do you like cycling? Do you have a bike?
I don't. So I like cycling in the countryside where it's quiet and safe, but I don't like cycling in the city. I'm not very brave about cycling in London, where I live, because there's lots of traffic and lots of buses. So no, I don't have a bike. Sorry, Rob.
No bike at all. I mean, I know what you mean. Cycling in the city can be dangerous. Although in London, there are a lot of cycle lanes now. They're trying to make
it's better, safer. Isn't it? You do it. You do it all the time when you come to work. So maybe I need to be a little bit braver.
And of course, the other thing in London and in many cities, you can hire out bikes, can't you? Sort of on the street.
You can.
Cycle somewhere and drop it off.
You can. And I do sometimes use those. So I don't own one, but if I need to get somewhere quickly, I can jump on a bike and pay a little bit of money. So there are options. Yeah.
We call that a sort of bike rental scheme, don't you? Renting a bike. Yeah.
Exactly. Mm. Yeah.
Okay. Well, okay. If you did have a bike.
I would have to look after it.
What would you do? You'd have to look after it. And that brings us on to our question, doesn't it?
My question is about looking after the bike. So here it is. I'll say it a few times. This is the first time. So to make my bike work properly, I need the chain. So I think you talked about what the chain was before, didn't you? So I need to beep the chain. These are your 4 options. Oil. Oiling, or oiled? Should I say that again?
I think you should, yes, please.
Yes. To make my bike work properly, I need the chain. 4 options are oil, to oil, oiling, or oiled.
Okay, ooh, quite a challenge. We're not writing this down. This is for you to listen to. So it's a listening exercise here. So what is that missing word or words?
Yeah. It's a question about verbs, isn't it? It's actually quite similar to, I think, question 2 on the quiz. So if you liked question 2, then maybe you'll like this question as well. It's about verbs and how they work together. That's my clue.
Okay. Well, we'll reveal the answer later on. The answers are coming in from our audience already, so I'll take a look at those. When can we see you again?
You probably can't see me, but you can hear me on the next episode of 6 Minute English, which is on Facebook and YouTube and our website and our app. So I look forward to being in your ears next Thursday.
Fantastic. Thank you, Sam. And it's nearly the weekend here in the UK. Any big plans?
I know. I'm seeing a friend on Sunday and we're going to a food and drink festival, which sounds delicious, but I'll let you know how it goes on Monday, Rob.
Okay. And you won't be going on your bike, will you?
And there's no bike. There's no bike involved. No exercise, just eating. It's not very healthy.
Fantastic.
I hope you enjoy your cycle after the quiz.
Thank you.
And enjoy your weekend, everyone. Lovely to see you.
Thanks for your question. Bye, Sam.
Bye-bye.
There goes Sam with her question. Thank you, Sam. Right, let's get back to the quiz. So that was question number 5, and some of you have given me an answer already. Let's put a few up on the screen here. I need to oil the chain. Somebody else is saying it should be I need oiled the chain. Other people are saying, here we go, another one here. I need to oil the chain. To oil the chain. I need oil the chain. Okay, so different answers coming in. I will give you the correct answer a little later on. Thank you for sending me your messages anyway. And again, carry on telling me where you're watching from all around the world. I'm here in the UK with today's Friday Live English quiz from BBC Learning English. We have 8 questions, so we've got 3 more to come. So come on, Rob, let's get a move on. Let's go to question number 6 on our cycle theme. And this one is about spelling. And this can be a real nuisance, a real pain if you're out cycling. And you go, oh no, I've got a puncture. I've got a puncture, which is like a flat tire. You know, there's a hole in the tube that goes inside the tire. Anyway, how do you spell puncture? You've got 4 options there. What is the correct spelling of puncture? Puncture. It's a funny word, isn't it? Puncture. How do you think you spell it? A, P-U-N-C-H-U-R-E. B, P-U-N-C-T-U-R-E. C, P-U-N-T-C-H-U-R-E. Or D, P-U-N-T-C-H-O-R. And let's have a look at what you are saying. And it looks like a lot of you are saying B. Answer B. Let's have a look at who's saying B. Let's put a few names up on the screen. Yeah, great. Okay, anybody else? A lot of you saying B. Okay, are you sure you're right? Let's have a look. Right. Good. You think it's spelt as B. Excellent. All right. Oh, somebody's saying C there. Puncture. Puncture. Anybody else? Anything different from B? You've got a different answer there. And I is also saying puncture. Okay, good. That's got you thinking, hasn't it? The spelling of puncture. All right, let's move on now to question number 7. Round 7. Here we are. Again, you've got to decide what goes in the gap. She's been riding a bike since 2 years. She's been riding a bike for 2 years. She's been riding a bike for all year. And she's been riding a bike for 2 years since. What's the answer to this one? On our cycling-themed English quiz, what are you saying to this one? Is the answer A, B, C, or D? Do tell me in the comments. The comments are the place, of course, for you to tell me where you're watching from as well. And also do tell me if you like cycling and if you have a bike. I'd like to know that as well. But also give me the answers to our questions. So question number 7, what is the correct answer? Let's have a look. Let's put some of you up on screen. She's been riding a bike since 2 years, says Lourdes. We've got a hello from Libya. So hello, Libya. And your answer was A. So I've lost your message, but thank you anyway. Somebody else is saying she's been riding a bike for all year, says Samba. A few more A's coming in here. Since 2 years. She's been riding a bike since 2 years. Somebody else thinks it's A as well. Leon says it's A. Where's Bill today? I haven't heard from Bill yet. Bill's always here. Another A there from Ali. Angela says it's B. She's been riding a bike for 2 years. Ayaz also says for 2 years. Got a quick hello to Shazad in Afghanistan. Hello to everybody in Afghanistan this afternoon. Okay, so we've got some B's, but we've also got some A's and some C's coming in. So again, that's just great. We've got you thinking. It's not too easy for everybody, which is nice because we like a bit of a challenge on our Friday Live quiz, don't we? Zin says she's been riding a bike for 2 years since. Okay. What is the right answer going to be? You're going to have to hang on a little bit longer to find out the correct answer. We've got one more question to come and then I will reveal the answers. Okay, let's move on then to question number 8. And this is about this phrase. A phrase we use in English and we say, it's just like riding a bike. Oh yeah, it's just like riding a bike. What does it mean? Okay, well, it means once you learn how to do something, you'll never remember it again. You'll forget it. Or once you learn how to do something, you'll never forget how to do it. Or once you learn how to do something, you'll find it hard work. So what does that phrase mean? It's just like riding a bike. Have you heard that phrase before? What do you think it means? Tell me in the chat, in the comments, and I shall have a look. It's just like riding a bike. Okay, what does it mean? If you don't know the answer, do have a guess. We're having fun today. There's no prizes. Just have a guess. Right, what are people saying? What do you think it actually really means? Let's put some of your answers up on the screen. Tutan says it means you'll never forget how to do it. Whereas we had a C just come in then. Oh, I've missed it now. Let's go to some more answers. Ong says it means you'll never remember how to do it again. So does Islam also thinks it means once you learn it, you'll never remember it. Whereas Martha thinks once you learn it, you'll never forget it. You'll never forget how to do it. Okay, so again, different answers coming in here. Great. Well, thank you for taking part. Anyway, it's great you're giving me your answers. Don't forget also to keep telling me where you're watching from today. Okay, Badasso thinks once you learn how to do something, you'll never forget how to do it. So answer B there. Let's put some other names up. There you go. I'm trying to get as many names up as possible. That's a good one. Happy Me says Friday quiz is just like riding a bike. What does that mean, I wonder? Is there a clue there? I've got option C. You're saying you can't see option C. Okay, let's have a quick look. If I can clear the screen, there's option C again. So the phrase, it's just like riding a bike. What does it mean? You'll never remember it again. Once you learn something, you'll never remember it. Once you learn something, you'll never forget it. Or once you learn it, you'll still find it very hard work. Right. Great. Look at all those answers pouring in on my screen there. Thank you so much for taking part. Just to remind you once again, this is the live English quiz. We do this every Friday, 1:30 UK time. And it's coming to you from BBC Learning English. And my name is Rob. Okay. Are we all having a good time out there? I hope we are. I hope you're having fun. This is the moment you've all been waiting for. It is now time to bring on the answers to see how clever you really are. So do you remember question number 1 on our cycling theme? What do you call someone who rides a bike? Is it a cycler? Is it cycling, cyclist or cyclist? And the answer was, of course, answer C, a cyclist. A cyclist, spelt like that, that is what we call somebody who rides a bike. They are a cyclist. It's a noun word. We just call someone a cyclist, not a cycler in this example. Sometimes you might put ER on the end of something, but here it is IST, a cyclist. Did you know that? Do let me know in the comments. Let's have a look. Yeah, people are giving me the answer again. I want to know how many got right. So far, for example, Jessica has got 1 out of 8 right. That's a good start, isn't it? Who else has got 1 out of 8? There you go. Got it right. Well done. Well done. Okay, good. Brilliant. Okay, it's a new word for you. Well, that's great. It's good to know you've learned new things. Okay, let's move on now to the answer to question number 2. And this was to fill in this gap in this sentence. And I asked, if you need something, fixing your bike, just let me know. What word goes in that gap or words? The options were help, to help, or helping. if you need, the correct answer was, of course, help. If you need help fixing your bike, just let me know. So we just say the word help. We don't have to say to help, okay, or helping. Help, of course, is an uncountable noun. So, you know, it's something you can't really count help, can you? So it's an uncountable noun. So we don't say, do you need a few helps or some help or a bit of help? It's just help. We don't need to say to, and it's not continuous helping. It's just help. Okay, we just use the word on its own, help. You could say some help if you want. That's a more informal way of saying it. But we don't say, do you need to help? It's just, in this context, help. Now, I'd like to see who's got that one right. So let's go and have a look at my comments here. And I can see, yeah, we've got some 2 out of 2s coming in here. So that's good. Give yourself a pat on the back if you've got 2 out of 8 so far. If you didn't get it, don't worry. So here we're using help as a noun, not as a verb. To help is the verb. Do you want to help me? But here it's just help on its own. If you need help, help. All right. So need plus noun, we're saying there. Thank you. Yes, that's a good, you've summed it up for me nicely. Need plus noun. Who else got it? Yeah, fantastic. 2 out of 8 here. Sorry, I keep pausing. That's because I'm looking at the comments coming in all on the same screen. All right. Rahila's got 2 out of 8. Wonderful, wonderful. Don't worry if you haven't got full marks yet. We are just having fun today. It's about testing your knowledge. If you don't know it, just have a guess. Okay. Okay. Good. Right. Wonderful. That's question number 2. All right. Let's go and find out what the answer is to question number 3, shall we, on our cycling themed quiz. Round 3. I asked you this question. Oh, I didn't ask a question. I asked you to complete this sentence. For the next 2 weeks, I will have been training for the Tour de France. I will be training for the Tour de France. I will be going for the Tour de France. Okay. Well, the correct answer for this was B. I will be training. Okay, because we're looking to the future here, aren't we? It's the next 2 weeks, not now, not the last 2 weeks. We are looking to the future. This is an example of the future perfect. Did you get that right? Will be training. So when you're going to be doing a continuous action in the future, we use this future. Of course, we're going to use this example. So I will be doing a continuous action in the future. So here, I will be training. I will be training for the Tour de France. This is just an example, by the way. I will not be training for the Tour de France. I am not fit enough. I might be watching it, but I won't be doing it. Okay. But anyway, it's the next 2 weeks, something you'll be continually doing for the next 2 weeks. It's coming up. It's not in the past. Just a reminder, we use future continuous to describe activities which are in progress at a future time. Okay. And it's formed of the simple future of to be and the present participle. Okay. There's lots more about this, lots more detailed information on our website at bbclearningenglish.com. So do check that out after the quiz. We're short on time here. Okay. Let's see what you got right. So let's have a look. D. Right, let's have a look. I got it. Well done. I got it. Venge has got 3 out of 3. Happy Me has given me another example. So let's put that up. So you've got 3 out of 3. Happy Me. Well done. It's future perfect tense. Yes. I will be traveling to the North Pole in the next 2 weeks. Great example. Thank you very much. Okay. Anybody else? Let's have another look. Anybody else want to give me their scores? Yeah, Dowran has got 3 out of 3. So well done. We have another 3 out of 3 here and a 3 out of 3 here. And Blue Phantom has got 2 out of 8. Not a bad score, is it? Well done. Well done. Okay, let's move on now to the answer to question number 4. And this is our picture round where you had to match the pictures with the words. 3 words, 3 pictures. And here are your correct answers. So A was pedals. They're the things you put your feet on to make the wheels go round, the pedals. The frame is the main structure of the bike, the metal part that has all the crossbar and bits and pieces that hold it all together. That is the frame, the frame. And then the small, thin pieces of metal that hold the wheel together, they're called the spokes. One spoke is spoke, more than one, spokes. Spokes. So these are the things in the wheel that hold the wheel together. Did you get that right? Did you know those words? And do tell me if you didn't, because I'd like to know if you've learned something new today. Let's have a look. Let's see what you're saying. Yeah. Okay. What did we say? Sally's got 3 out of 8. Another 3 out of 8 coming in there. Tarek's now got 4 out of 8. So well done, Tarek. 4 out of 8 there. And yeah, you've got them all correct. So well done. Well done. Badasso's got 4 out of 8. Hope you're enjoying the quiz out there. And a lot of you saying you've got it and you've got 4 out of 4 correct so far. So well done. Hopefully you're enjoying the quiz. Not too easy for you today. A lot of you having really good scores today, though, so that's fantastic. Hopefully you've learned some new words as well, and hopefully you're enjoying yourself. And I do hope you told your friends all about this quiz today. All right. Wonderful. Okay, so that was kind of vocabulary, and that was just kind of testing out your knowledge of parts of a bike. Right. Somebody said, here we are. That's great. IELTS Cusco says, I did not know about spokes. There you go. You've learned a new word, spokes. Ah, Bill is here and he has 4 out of 4. Well done, Bill. Right. Well done if you got those right. Don't worry if you didn't. We're just having fun on our live Friday quiz. I think we should move on now to the answer to question number 5. And this is the question that Sam told us about. She came on the show, told us that she doesn't ride a bike in London. It's too dangerous. But she did give us a cycle related question. And it was this one. To make my bike work properly, I need something, the chain. I need something, the chain. And the options were oil the chain, to oil the chain, oiling the chain, or oiled the chain. And the correct answer was B, to oil. I need to oil the chain. It's important there to have that word to in there, to oil. Okay, did you know that? Did you get that? Yeah, because of course, when you have need, you have to have the word to. This is all about verb patterns, of course, verb patterns. Check it out on our website. After need, we always use the infinitive to plus verb. So here we are, we have to and oil to oil, the verb to oil. That came after the word need. Okay, so oil on its own wouldn't work. We need to oil. I need oiling the chain, doesn't fit. And oiled is sort of past tense, just doesn't fit. Let's give you some other, I've got other examples of verb patterns here. Want plus the infinitive, to plus the verb. Enjoy plus a gerund. Okay, and sometimes they can be followed by both. So remember plus infinitive, remember to. Or remember and gerund, remembering. Okay. There's lots more about it on our website, bbclearningenglish.com. So do check it out. But here, just remember that after need, when you need to do something, you need the word to as well, plus the verb. So let's see how we got on. Right. Rahida's still down at 4 out of 8. Let's see how we're getting on. Right. Here we go. I'm just trying to find some. Here we go. Right. The chain needs oiling. You can say the chain needs oiling, but we're talking about your need to do something. Okay. different context there. AJ Styles, AJ says 5 out of 5. So that's fantastic. Iona's got 5 out of 5 as well. Fans got 4 out of 8, which is still a very nice score. What else we've got going on here? 2 out of 8 for Caesar. Right, 5 out of 8 there. Okay, so you're all doing very well today. I'm proud of you out there. Some great scores in our cycle quiz today. Do tell me as well. Are you going to go riding your bike this weekend? Are you a cyclist? Do tell. Do tell in the chat here. All right. Good. Some good scores. Okay, I think we should move on now. Evgeny's got it right. Well done, Evgeny. Nice to see you. Okay, let's move on now to our next question. Question number 6. And this is our spelling round. And it was all about that thing you get when you get a thorn or a piece of glass through your tire into the tube. The inside of the tire, there's a thing called an inner tube. It's inside, it's inner tube. And of course, when you get a hole in that, the air comes out and you get what we call a puncture. Puncture. Interesting pronunciation as well as a spelling. Puncture. So I tried to trick you with some of the spelling here, but the actual correct spelling was B. Puncture. Puncture. You've got a ch sound there, haven't you? Not a puncture. 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 There it is. There's the spelling. P-U-N-C-T-U-R-E. That was the correct spelling of puncture. So how'd you get on there? Iona's got already got 6 out of 6. So that's a nice, good, healthy score. Sam has got 6 out of 6 as well. AJ's got 6 out of 6. This is good. It's good to know, for example, that Floweret says it's something new for you. That's great. You've learned something new. Wonderful. Good. Yeah, I can see that some of you are getting good scores here. But as I said, don't worry. This is just for fun. It's all about having a go, isn't it? All right, let's put some more names up on the screen here and see how we are doing. Happy Me says puncture. Yeah, the tire that has a hole in it. Yeah, it's not actually the tire, actually. It's the inner tube, the stuff inside the tire that gets the hole. But of course, you get the hole through the tire into the inner tube. The air comes out and you have to fix it. Can be a real pain. Right, okay, you got it right. 6 out of 8 there. We have a 5 out of 6 so far. Yeah, okay. Good scores, everyone. Well done. Hope you're having fun. 2 more answers to go. Let's move on now to question number 7. Another complete sentence. She's been riding a bike since 2 years. She's been riding a bike for 2 years. She's been riding a bike for all year, or she's been riding a bike for 2 years since. And the correct answer was B. She's been riding a bike for 2 years. Yes, notice that word for, not the number 4, of course, the other kind of for, F-O-R, for 2 years. She's been riding a bike for 2 years. Did you know that? Yeah, okay. She's been riding a bike for 2 years. This is all about using either since or for. So we use since with a specific past point in time. So since the 5th of June, I haven't been eating chocolate. You've got a specific date there, since. But when it's more a general duration, a period of time, we say for 2 years. Now, if she had been riding a bike and started on the 1st of January, we would have said she's been riding a bike since the 1st of January. But we're talking about a general period of time, 2 years. So we say for, not since. Okay, for 2 years. Okay, now let's see who got that one right. Okay, AJ's got 7 out of 7. Well done. Let's also have a look. You think number 1 is since 2 years? No, number 1, I'm afraid, is not correct. Since, because it's not a specific time. 7 out of 8 for Barasso. Well done. She's been, yeah, okay. Yeah, lots of questions coming in here. Okay, Nancy's got 4 out of 6. Yara's got 6 out of 8 so far. All good scores. Well done for taking part. Great. Somebody's asking me. Oh, right, okay. Let's see if we can answer this one. Hello, Rob. How long have you been riding the bike? This bike is a new bike, so I've been riding it for a few months. But I've been riding a bike since I was very small, probably since I was about 5 years old. I've been riding bikes and really enjoy it. Thank you for asking. Okay. Please explain B, not A. Okay, again, B, just one more time, I'll explain that. For, we use for when it's a period of time. So 2 years is a period of time. If it's a specific date you're talking about, so if you've been riding a bike and you started on a date, say the 1st of January, then we use since, okay? She's been riding a bike since the 1st of January, specific time. But 2 years is a period of time, so we use for. Right, hope that's clear now. There's more about for and since on our website at BBC Learning English. Okay. Right, what else? Got people telling me they've not cycled. That doesn't matter. You can still take part in the quiz. Okay, right. 7 out of 7 for Omar. Right, thank you for taking part in that. Let's get the answer to the final question, question number 8. The phrase, it's just like riding a bike, means once you learn how to do something, you'll never remember it again. Or B, you'll never forget how to do it. Or C, you'll find it hard work. Okay, well, that phrase actually means this one. Once you learn how to do something, you'll never forget how to do it. Because when we use this expression, it's just like riding a bike. You never forget how to ride a bike, or that's the theory anyway. That once you learn how to ride a bike, you never forget how to ride it. So when you say, it's just like riding a bike, it means you never forget it. It's every time you do it, it's easy. You just do it automatically. It's easy. You never forget how to do it. It's just like riding a bike. So I don't know if that's true for you, but you know, if you don't go on a bike for several years and then you have you find a bike, you get on your bike, you just automatically remember how to cycle again, don't you? So this is what this phrase means. It's just like riding a bike. You learn how to do it once, you always remember how to do it. So that's that English phrase. So how did we get on? Let's find out who's got some good scores. Nancy got 4 out of 8. That's good. Lady got 5 out of 8. Wow, these messages are coming so quickly. I can't keep up. Alessandra got 8 out of 8. Nice. Well done. You'll never forget how to do it. 8 out of good quiz. Oh, thank you very much. Happy me. I'm glad you enjoyed it. You can call me Happy Me now. Your message made me happy. 3 out of 8 and 8 out of 8. Let's just put some of your names up on screen with your scores, just so you can see your name in lights. There you go. Well done. Well done. Well done, everybody. May's got 8 out of 8 as well. Helen's got 8 out of 8. Got a 3 out of 8, 8 out of 8. Excellent stuff. Okay. I know some people found it easy. Other people found it a challenge. But I do hope that some of you have learned things. Like Badasso says, I've got 8 out of 8 today. I learned a lot. So great stuff. Wonderful. Good. So I hope you learned something. I hope you've had fun. By the way, if you did miss the quiz or you missed some of it or you want to show your friends, we're going to put this quiz up again on YouTube and on Facebook so you can play it again. Catch up on your questions. Okay. Good. I'm just reading your comments. Thank you so much. Look at this one. Sohail, this lesson was outstanding and enjoyable. Wow, thank you so much. That's brilliant. I hope you've enjoyed it. I hope you've learned something. And I hope you've had fun. And I do hope you've told your friends as well. Okay. It's been great to see you out there. And thank you so much for all your messages. Thank you very much. Have a nice weekend. I hope you have a nice weekend too, everybody. Thank you for taking part in our quiz today, all about cycling. Do join us again next Friday. As always, 1:30 UK time. Dylan is back next week with his quiz. He'll be here for our live English quiz to test your English knowledge. But in the meantime, don't forget we have live lessons every day here on Facebook and YouTube at 1:30 UK time. And we have lots of learning English material at bbclearningenglish.com. That is the place to go. Okay, thanks so much for all your kind messages. You've been fantastic. I have been Rob. And I guess it's just time now just to say stay safe and have a good weekend. Bye for now, everybody, and take care. Bye-bye. Bye.